14. I'm sorry, that was not right on the points. Hey, Ben. We're not underneath the colors there, and I don't know which one's which. Here, just a second. Okay, so that was the red team. Now, the blue team's points. Blue team's points are 230,000. Very, very close. Now, it's time for the gold, or yellow, or orange. Who will be first and who will be second? So we've got one team has 240,000, and the other team has 250,000. So we'll take it now to see who has the winning team, okay? With 240,000 points is the second place team. First place with 250,000 points is the first place team. Okay, good. And it's first, second, third, fourth, right? So the first team is in first place, the second place team is in second place, and the third place team is in third place, and the fourth team is fourth place is in fourth place. Isn't that good? Great. So, I'll tell you, okay, it is either the orange or the gold that has 240,000. Give them a cheer. Alright, do you want to know who's in first place? 250,000 points. Isn't that good? Okay. In second place, 240,000 points is the orange team, and in first place, 250,000 is the yellow team. Where's the yellow flag? Where's the yellow flag? There it is, yeah. Okay, all right. How many of you like that screen? Oh, I like ice cream. Do you ever go to Dairy Queen? Do they have Dairy Queens where you live? Oh, and ice cream, everything. What's this?
Right there.
the whole thing. They eat the whole thing. The pickle and all. Pickle and everything, okay? Okay? They gotta eat it all. I see a clean mouth on the inside. Pickle and the whipped cream. Pickle and the whipped cream. Okay? Gotta chew it all up and have it swallowed. Here we go. 50 or 75,000 points for first place. Okay? Here we go. Ready? Thank you.
you for the enjoyment of this camp this week, the contest of Hometown, and I help us to focus on the preaching, the building up of our wisdom from the Bible. Help me, help them, help us to seek for wisdom and grab it. Pray that you'll help our lives to see as we grab the wisdom to build it up. Help our life, our house, in Jesus' name. Amen. Be seated.
Oh,
14, verse 26. But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things, and bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I have said unto you. Wisdom will teach you all things. The Holy Spirit. He will teach you all things. Learning. Wow. The Holy Spirit teaches you all things. He will give you wisdom as he teaches you. Amen. The world, they think they're smart, but the Holy Spirit teaches us all things. For wisdom. Amen. Proverbs 11:2. When pride cometh, it cometh shame, but with the lowly is wisdom. Wisdom makes you humble. If you're being here today, I know what to do. I'm proud of myself. That's my wisdom. Being here. Humble yourself. Get wisdom. It makes you humble. Are you humble today? Are you big-headed? You think you know everything? I know. What's wrong? That's not wisdom. You'll mess up your life. You need to humble yourself. How? Wisdom will help you be humble. Pride will destroy you. Pride will destroy you. Humbleness gives you wisdom.
Don't worry about the worldly friend knocking on you and troubling on you.
for thy testimonies are my meditation. Do you have more understanding than all your teachers together? Wisdom of God helps you know, helps you understand. Teachers of public schools, NIU, Illinois, Gallaudet, NDIT, all of these schools that men go to, you're a Christian, you'll have more understanding than all your gloomy teachers. You'll have wisdom. Now, verse 103. How sweet are thy words unto my taste, yea, sweeter than honey to my mouth. God's word is delicious. I don't know, you don't need your Bible, but the words in it are sweeter than honey. God's word is good. Notice 105, verse 105. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Wisdom. Wisdom. Thy word, wisdom, shines like a light on your life. As you live day by day, you have light, you have understanding. You don't need to fall and hurt yourself. You don't need to fall in sin. You don't need. Wisdom will teach you that God's word is a light. That's good. Proverbs chapter 4. Proverbs 4, 5 through 7.
They were sleeping in the same bed right near each other. Both had babies.
cute baby, and she's like, that's not my baby. It's a dead baby, but it's not mine. Hey, you got my baby. You got my baby. No, that's my baby. Yours is a dead baby. No, that's my baby. Fuss, fuss, fuss. What do you do? What's the problem? The different king, King Solomon. The King Solomon? I got a problem. What's the problem? And they explained. His mother was sleeping. She crushed her baby. He died. She swapped babies. She was, that's my baby. That's really my baby. No, no, no. And they have that lie, lie, lie. And the king couldn't. He didn't know. He didn't know his mother was the real mother for the live baby. What do you think? Wisdom. I need wisdom. Oh, I know what to do. Soldier, here. Bring me my live baby. Oh, cute baby. One of one live, one dead. Give me the live baby. Now, soldier, bring me your sword. And I hold the baby. And I'm going to cut the baby right in half and give each mother half of the baby. Is that all right? Mother said, fine, fine, fine. That's fine. The real mother said, no, 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 don't kill my baby. Let the other lady have my baby. But don't kill the baby. That's fine. And the king's wisdom, he knew that who the true mother was. Who's the true mother? Who's the one who said, fine? Or the one that says, oh, no, give it to the other lady. This one, I don't care. And oh, she's a liar. She's not the real mother. That's fine. I like that. So the real mother said, no, no, let the other lady have the baby, don't kill my baby. And the king knew that's the real mother. She wanted to keep the baby alive, and she gave it to the real mother. The other mother was mad, but the real mother said, thank you, King Solomon, thank you. Wisdom, the king had wisdom. Wow. How? King before, all night, he was sleeping. Wisdom, money, what do you want? You want fame? The king thought, he said, well, wisdom, a lot of money, fame. You know, God, I want wisdom. Jesus. I said, you chose wisdom, you're smarter than all. And I'm going to give you wisdom, I'm going to give you riches and fame, both. And he became a very wealthy man. The world knew him. Very famous man because he asked for wisdom and not money or fame. So I've been saying, you need to ask God, please give me wisdom. Give me wisdom. You can have wisdom. Last Sunday in the morning, a dead person said, explain to me, I've got to make you my problem. That person's dead always goes to low, not smart. And he always asked, give me some money, give me some money. And that poor, slow man, look, give me money, give me money, give me money. He doesn't know that every Sunday, always, that poor would go to that same man, but they know he has no money. I said, who? Somebody gave me the name. I said, okay, I'll take care of him. I'll see about it. Later, I caught him. Now the slow person got a goal. I said, you bother him and take advantage of his money? No, no, no. So I went to that person. I held the slow. He said, always bother money. Give me money, give me money, give me money. And that person wouldn't tell me, but he always told me, bother, 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 bother. But we blocked me from bothering that slow person and taking his money. I said, we discussed it. We explained it. And he understood. He said, listen, be careful you don't blow him out of the crash at first or blame them or get mad at them. Listen to both sides of the story. They tell him there's a solution. So you ask. Don't make you strong. all of them together. Parents, I want you to be. The best thing parents can do for their children is to love each other. How many want to become rich? How many want to become rich? You are richer today if you have laughed. Laugh at a good time, you're happy. People that laugh sometimes are sick or they complain all the time. But you, when you laugh, give forgiveness, that's richer. Number 7. For every minute you are angry with someone, you lose 60 seconds of happiness that you could never get back. Happy, happy, happy. I mean, someone fuss and fight and mad, angry. For 1 minute, and that minute's gone, you look at that minute back, it's gone. The anger destroys a minute of your life. Won't you be happy? Not angry. Send it a time back. Number 8. Wisdom gives you long life. The last one, number 9. Plan ahead. It wasn't raining when Noah built the ark. Remember Noah, he built an ark? Planned ahead. God told him to build it. There's no rain, and then they've never seen rain. 120 years he built a big boat. Man, and he built it, got ready. When it was finished, as soon as it started raining, the floods came up to save his family. Plan ahead, have wisdom. What do I do? Plan ahead. That's the wisdom. That's counseling. For your life. Give wisdom. Now this morning, did I want you to give wisdom? No, I don't need that. It's not that important. Don't be foolish. Catch it. Get it. Apply it to your life. Oh, that's good. Wisdom, counsel, influence. Doing what is right. Doing your counseling. Maybe I'm going to do. Then ask your father. Or ask your captain. Or ask a school teacher. I had a question. I had a problem. Can I talk to you privately? What's your problem? What am I going to do about this? Oh, okay. And they can help explain, give you ideas and ways to help you take care of your problem. Thank you, thank you. When you go on your mind. Thank you for your application. Thank you. Okay? Oh, that's good. Wisdom. It's important. You know the world, ask the world's help, they'll advise you wrong. They don't have God's wisdom. You ask the right person with the right wisdom. You ask me. I'll be happy to help you. You ask Debbie. You ask Miss Jeffries. She has been much with her for many, many years. She'll help you. Jack Scott, my pastor, wow. He is so wise in his teaching and preaching. Really help. God's man. That's why we have a good preacher. Your home church, you have a good preacher. Your preacher is willing to help you. Ask for wisdom. He's there for you. The Bible, read it, pray. If you don't have wisdom, pray. Ask God to give you wisdom. That's important. Wisdom is gold. It's better than gold. It's better than silver. Wisdom fills your mind. Get wisdom, get it in, build it up, get your mind full of wisdom. Wisdom to the Bible. Ask people who are wise for real. Get it in your mind. Increase, increase, increase. Later, you can help others because your mind is full of wisdom, God's wisdom, and you read the Bible, you pray, you prepare yourself. filled up your life. Let us rise and build. Wisdom will build your house, your body. Please stand. Raise your hand, another beside. I will seek for wisdom daily.